Hello, welcome back to Go and Walkabout. Today it's about Flutter and Google Firestore. If you're new to the channel, I'm a native iOS developer and I developed a mobile travel diary that is available in the App Store. Now I'm exploring Flutter for building an Android application. So I'm not a Flutter expert, but I'll take you along with my experiences with Flutter. And today we're going to replicate our trip screen. Now here you see what we want to achieve. It's a simple screenshot of the existing iOS app, and I want to replicate this as good as possible. Now before we go into code, I'll first show you some of the data structures that I've been using. The whole application is built on Firestore, and the data structure has been optimized for reads. So there's a lot of redundant data, making the data store a little bit more complex than it's actually need to be. But this is all done for optimal performance when retrieving trips and updates about trips, etc. And this screen is built from a single query from a single list of documents. And I'll show and explain to you how and where the data is coming from. So we actually have trips, and if we open a trip, we have followers. And the list shows all the trips that you own and that you follow. That means we query this subcollection of followers here. And then we get into a document, and in this document, we see a relatively complex data structure with nested objects. Now, just to keep it simple, we have a reference to the trip that we're talking to. That means we can directly get the title. So it's not a reference in terms of referring to another document, but we redundantly store some basic attributes about the trip. The same for the user we're talking about. We know whether it's a shared trip or not, and the role of owner. They were not relevant for the view we're going to create today, but it's there. But much more important, we also have here a recent, so that we can see from each trip what has been the recent update. And that exists of a collection of media, those are images, and from each image, we know an ID of the image, we know what is the content type, and we know the aspect ratio. And the aspect ratio will be important in the future, or when we're building the list, as you will see quickly. It's a list of media. It has a message. It has the actual post that triggered, or the ID of the post and the message of that post, and again, the user. Now, this, let's say, relatively nested structure we have in Firestore. And that is a given thing, and we need to retrieve that in an appropriate way. Now, what have I done first? I first went to create some model objects. So let's start with the trip user. And I use the name trip user because that's also the name I've used in iOS. And I want to keep it as similar as possible just to avoid confusion for me. And that list of the trip user that has a reference to a trip, as you saw, it has a trip reference to a user, the role created, updated, and to a recent data structure. Now, when we get this trip user document from a document from a document snapshot from Firestore, we need to parse that into a proper object. So we use the trip, the user, the role that created, and the recent. And you see on the trip, the user, those are objects I created here as well. Let's take a look at the trip where we have from JSON, where we set the ID, name, and description. The same for the user. We can get that from JSON, and that way we can populate it. A little bit more complicated is the recent one. So if we get the recent one from JSON, what you saw here from the trip user, we call the from JSON, and we get the, well, we do a little bit of a casting to make the internal data structure from a Firestore document look as JSON. We can restore that into the recent, and the recent will set the user, the message, and then the media, what is actually a list of media objects again, and each media object has an ID, content type, aspect ratio, etc. Now, with that way, we can very easily take a Firestore document and parse it into a collection of objects that we can use throughout the product. The next thing I did, and I know this is not the place where it should be, but for now I made a static member to retrieve a list of trips for a particular user. In the future, I'll probably move this to a separate repository or something, But for now, it is just sitting here, and that does a collection group query on the followers. It still hard codes it for now on a user because I don't have the global user ID ready yet. And it orders it by descending. It gets the documents, and for each, it adds it to the trips. Now, this actually returns here a future with a list of trip users. So it's not anymore returning document snapshots, but it is really trip user objects that it is returning. And then it becomes interesting because now we need to tie this into the user interface. If I go into the user interface here in my, let's say, trips screen, we see we have a trips view, and just to go a little bit better back, it starts here in the home screen that if we click on the first tab, we go to the trips view. That is the trips view we are having here. That is the trips view, and in the trip view, and now I am still experimenting whether I should use view models or blocks and provide them or not, etc. For now, I've settled using a very, very simple block, as you will see. And this is the beginning of the whole development. So it's not full-fledged yet. There's still many things wrong with it, but it is a start to work on and to continue on further. So what do? I use provider to provide my trip block that I create, and we'll get into a minute. I create that, I init it, and I call my trip list. And now in my trip list, we can retrieve the block, the business logic object, and we can use a stream builder on the list of the trip user with the block of the data stream. So actually, my block is returning a stream with a list of trip users. And based on that, see, a snapshot list trip user, I build my user interface. And that interface is simple. While it's waiting, I show loading. And otherwise, I go into a layout builder. And there it becomes interesting because I need the dimensions for creating the view. Now, if you look here, you see we have images with different aspect ratios. Here you can actually see it better. And I want to show those four images on a row with the correct aspect ratio. And that was a little bit tricky before I actually had it working correctly. But I need the layout builder so I can get the width of the screen that I'll use for calculating the correct height of that particular row. And we'll get to that in a minute. We have a list view. That list view is actually using the snapshot data, what is a list of trip users that I've gotten from the stream builder. And for each, I return a card. In that card, I create a column. Set my first row here with my text, what is actually the name of the trip. I put the date next to it. That's what you see here. I have my, you know, name of the trip. I have the date. Then I have created an image list, what is a widget, what will actually render this that we'll go into in a minute. And then I do a little bit of padding, and I have another child here, what is actually this body text. The card is styled in such a way that it looks like this card, etc. Let's go into the image list. The image list is giving me a trip user because I need to get the media from that trip user object. And it is given the width. And what I do now is I get the image count because it's not always four images, could be one to four images. And I calculate the effective width of my widget, what I have here. So I get the length, I subtract some thing of the margin. Between each image, there's a little bit of a separator, so I subtract that, etc. Then I calculate my width factor. And if you remember well, for each media object, I had the aspect ratio. So if the aspect ratio would be 1, as in this example, because they're all square, it is 4, and I know my total width, so I can calculate the height. And that's what I'm doing here. By adding all my aspect ratios, I can calculate here the height of this media. And then I create a media list. I go through all the media objects. I add to each size box with the correct height. Now, and this is what I needed to do. At first I thought, oh, it's very simple. I use the aspect ratio widget. I set the correct aspect ratio and then I put them in a row and it will work. And actually, it didn't, because the road doesn't know how to lay out that. And I actually had a wrong experience. By setting a height, a size box around it, I get the correct dimensions, and it's working fine now. Now, and then I return my size box, because I've built that, which is the row, and inside I have my media list. And I nicely render this whole screen. Now, before we go and show the result, we first need to touch a little bit on the block that I created to get this all working. And it's a very simple version, and it is also for me a first start, and I really like to build it from scratch because I learn a lot more in doing that. So I'll take you along here. My tree block has a data controller, and in it I need to dispose it, and I kept it really, really simple. I have a data sink, that's where you put in the stuff you want to have, and then I have a data stream. What is the output? And the data stream was actually what was used here in my trips view. You see here, I get my, my block, the data stream. So the data stream is changing, and then I can, it will automatically re-render. And what do I do in the init of my block? So I initialize it, then I will get my trips, as it said here. I call my trip user list for user list. Now, of course, later this will be a repository to disconnect the models from the actual querying of the data store. But for now, this works. And I add the result to the sink. If there's an action, I add the error to the sink or to the data controller, the error to continue. And that's all I need to do. Now, as you have noticed, I don't inherit from anything yet. I did use a change notifier because I was playing around with view models or not, but for now I've settled on not doing anything. And then in my trip list here, I can provide it with the standard provider. So I haven't built a block provider yet. Now, I guess I need to do that sometime in the future, but for now I just experiment with it this way, and it's working. That's what we're going to look at now, and it's a good start to get working. So let's go to the simulator, and here on the simulator you see the screen. Now, there's not much to it yet, but this is actually running on my my system. It nicely layouts the screen, it does the correct calculation, and it fetches the data. So this was a fundamental step for connecting to my Firestore database and Flutter, and working out a method that becomes repeatable to continue. I'm not 100% happy with it yet. The way you connect your block to your view is, in my opinion, still a little bit clumsy. But yeah, that's the way it works in Flutter. So you provide your block, either with a normal provider or block provider or something, and then inside the builder of my widget, I can retrieve that block. So I create it higher up in the widget tree, and then inside a lower level, I can retrieve it, and that way I can use it, and I can call also methods, maybe refresh or anything on it. I will continue improving on that, and I'll take you along on that journey. But for now, it's working. I'm happy with it, and it actually was less work than I expected, and I'm still in love with Flutter, and I'll continue working on it. I hope you liked this video. If you did so, please like and subscribe. If you didn't like the video, wait for the next one because it might be better for you. I'll thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.